Hello and welcome to VitoshAcademy. Today we'll be showing how to read data from the internet, and we'll concentrate on financial data that is delivered to us through APIs or simply in Wikipedia as a simple table. So let's start. So with Python, I have just taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 libraries, pretty much NumPy, Pandas, Yahoo Finance, requests, and datetime. Yahoo Finance I'll probably not be using, but let it stay there. We'll probably use it later in another video once we get the data so far. So the idea is first to get the data from here. Probably looks an easy task. You somehow found NASDAQ.com, their API, and you are curious to see what can you do with it. What do we want actually from it? It's simply the symbol here. And we can even make it a pretty print. So let's take this one and record it as a URL. As this one. And what else? We'll ask for response. We have already the response, the requests library here. So the response would be requests.get, and we use the URL. Headers would be headers and some timeout. Okay. While writing this, I'm seeing that I don't have headers. And the headers would be a simple dictionary where the user agent is Mozilla version 5.0, why not? And it accepts application JSON. Okay, fair enough. Let's try it. Timeout 10 seconds. Okay. The good thing while we are using Jupyter Notebook is that anytime we want to do something, we can see, hey, let me see what do I have in the response. In the response, I'm having 200, which is great. Yeah. So let's continue. The data that we need is in the response JSON. And it looks like this, pretty much. It is the same as this one. And what we want this symbol, AAPL, AMAT, AMGN in a list. So we have to go to the data, then again to the data, and then to the rows. Let's see how we're gonna do this. Tickers is our thing. So let's do it like this, data, then how many times I said data, and let's see what we're gonna do if we do this. Most probably nothing. How about this one? Again, nothing. Okay, now we are getting something, okay? Just so it doesn't come off out of the blue. Okay, data, okay? And then we can use rows. Data, rows, great. And then I'm curious to get what is in the first one. And I'm getting all the data for this AAPL company, which is APO Incorporated Common Stock. And alphabetically, this is the first one in NASDAQ. And if I use, for example, 12, I'll get the 12th company. Great. So what do I want? Furthermore, I'm interested in the symbol. Only in the symbol. Great. So I want to get this one and to get all the symbols. The Python way to do this, or the Pythonic way, to make this kind of lists that even have a name that I have forgotten. So we are looking for the symbol, this one, for each item in data rows. And I think we should have it. Yes. We can do, for example, different. We can get company name. And if we get this way, then we get these company names nicely. But as I said, we're looking for the symbol. And this is the way. So let's make this one a function. How would it look like? We'll name it def and then get tickers from Wikipedia, get NASDAQ tickers from Wikipedia, and then it should be something like this. Okay, quite an easy one, nothing fancy. Let's see whether it will work. And let's call it. And it works. Great. So far, so good. Let's continue with the second method, which is pretty much going to NASDAQ here and saying, okay, what can we do with this one? We can simply go into Wikipedia, copy and paste. It will work, but because we are supposed to be programmers, let's do something better. So what do we do now? We use again, well, we are going to use pandas, because pandas has one function called read HTML. Let's get this one and say this one is wiki URL. Yeah. And then with the wiki URL, we can say, okay, tables. And we can say read underscore HTML wiki URL. HTML, yeah, and now let's take a look. What do we have here? We got a lot of data that actually looks interesting. We see that PD read HTML somehow translated almost anything into a table, which is interesting. But yeah, so let's take a look at NASDAQ here and see, okay, first interesting table is record values. Do we have it? Probably not. Let's look for this one with Control F simply. Okay, it is here. Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. And which table should we be taking care of? This one. This one is the fourth table. So let's see how we are going to ask for it. Components table would be tables and then number four. And components table like this. Okay. Just curious, do we have table zero? Oh, yeah. Website. Okay, table zero is obviously this one here. For example, We can look it and we can find. So we have actually like five tables. This is our fifth tables. Let's see len tables how many it will give us. 18 tables. Quite a lot. So the idea here is to know what you are looking for and to play a bit. In this case, we got lucky without even knowing it. So we got the components table, and from the components table, it's already a pandas. So this PD read HTML actually did the magic. And the tickers should be, let's see, what's the name of the ticker? Oh, rather an easy one. Ticker makes sense. So to list actually makes list. And we can take a look and get it. Okay, fair enough. Let's make this one into a function. Def get NASDAQ tickers actually these ones are from Wikipedia, the previous ones are not from Wikipedia. Get NASDAQ tickers from API. Okay, and get NASDAQ tickers from Wikipedia. Interesting. We don't have a return here. Yes, now we have them. And before ending the video, I'm just curious to see how exactly are these ones different, whether they are absolutely the same or not. And the best way to do it is actually to make a dictionary and to see how many times, for example, we would be having apple from here and from here. They should be like two. Yeah, makes sense. Let's try. And trying it, we call something API tickers. And we name this get NASDAQ tickers from API. And then we get wiki tickers. And we get NASDAQ tickers from Wikipedia. Let's see whether we got it. Let's take a look at the length. 101, the other one is okay, they're 101 both. This means most probably they'll be the same, but let's try. So only in wiki, so set wiki tickers minus set API tickers, and pretty much the same, but the other way around. Only in API. Let's see. Okay. So it seems that our tickers are the same. Just to see that actually this works. Tickers add test. Great. List object. Okay, this wasn't this language. Let me see which one was it. Okay, it should be something with insert. Thank you. Should be the other way around then. Something like this. Yes. And only in wiki we have nothing, but only in API we have test, the one that I have just added. So this method here works. Great, I'm going to remove the test. And yeah, let's make some kind of a summary here. What did we do? We actually didn't do a lot. Pretty much we found a way to put data to lists from Wikipedia or from some API that gives us result and gives us JSON. I'll leave this one on GitHub, and so far so good. Thank you for watching VitoshAcademy. Enjoy the rest of your day and take care of yourself. Bye bye.